Trees are some of the biggest organisms on the planet. But where do they get that matter to grow?
It's nutrients out of the ground.
It's that soil, really, yeah.
Goodness out of the soil, I suppose.
Comes out of the soil?
Yeah.
Yeah. Goodness.
Goodness.
Mm. Why isn't there a big hole around the tree where it's taken out all the soil?
Because it doesn't say gradually that the soil has time to recover.
Now, I think it's intuitive to believe that the tree gets most of its mass from the soil, because you can see those roots digging into the soil and they must be taking something out of there. And I mean, a tree looks like dirt and it feels solid like dirt, but it's not. In the early 1600s, a scientist named Johann Baptist van Helmholtz tried to figure out where the mass of a tree was coming from. So he got a pot of soil and very carefully measured the amount of soil in there. Then he planted the tree and took care of it for 5 years, making sure that no soil left or was added to his pot. And at the end of this experiment, he weighed the tree to find that it was 72 kilograms, but the mass of soil had only decreased by about 60 grams. This was pretty strong evidence that the mass of the tree does not come from the soil.
I've never thought about that, actually, because they don't really eat anything, trees.
They don't eat anything?
No.
They don't eat anything?
Water is all they absorb.
That's all they eat?
Yeah.
They don't eat anything else?
No.
That's all they eat?
Well, presumably from the water and the nutrients from the soil.
Is there anything else that you need besides the soil and the water?
I suppose that's all you need, isn't it?
To make wood.
Other than the original seed for that particular tree, I suppose.
The seed and the soil and the water, and that makes this big tree.
Ooh.
Of course, Johann Baptist van Helmholtz did conclude that the tree was made entirely of water. Now, while that's not correct, at least he was on the right track, realizing that the matter of a tree doesn't come out of the soil.
The sun energy, yeah.
The sun energy?
Yeah.
Are they converting energy into mass, or do you know what I mean?
Yeah, I don't
like,
know.
Like, there wasn't stuff, and then there was. Like, where did that stuff come from?
Magic. I don't know.
My question is, where do they get that mass to grow big?
Sun. Get it from the rain and the sun, presumably.
Light.
A sunlight.
And the sunshine.
The sunshine? Does the sunshine add mass to the tree?
They wouldn't grow without it. I don't know whether it adds mass, but they wouldn't grow without it.
Of course, the sun's energy is needed for the tree to build the matter into its branches and leaves. But the sun itself, the energy, is not matter.
Well, I suppose we've got to put air into this as well. If
yeah.
There's got to be something out of the,
What is it about
the
air?
A gas in the air that it leaves as well.
Oxygen.
The trees need the oxygen.
Yeah, need the oxygen, don't they?
And I guess oxygen.
The oxygen, of course.
The oxygen?
Yeah.
Are there any ingredients that we're missing?
Carbon dioxide.
Carbon dioxide.
Carbon dioxide.
So would it surprise you to find out that 95% of a tree is actually
carbon dioxide.
From carbon dioxide? Trees are largely made up of air.
Yeah. Surprising. Yeah.
I need this reaction, like,
holy shit.
So as it turns out, trees are mostly made out of air, out of the carbon dioxide that they take in. And what's interesting is that we breathe out carbon dioxide and water. That's how we lose mass. But it's the exact same substances that trees breathe in to gain mass. So if you can imagine a closed system where it was just you and a tree, you would breathe out that carbon dioxide and water, the tree would take it in, so you would get smaller while the tree is getting bigger. And in a sense, you're becoming the tree.